Welcome, everyone. I have a beautiful story to tell you. Tonight is my dear friend's birthday, and she shared this story with me. A person goes to the Buddha and says, "I want happiness." And Buddha says, "Take away I, take away want, and what's left is happiness." Beautiful story. So, some people have asked to begin a choir for singing written music. So you have to have a good voice and you have to hopefully be able to read music. But I'm going to begin it, and the school is going to put up a notice for the students. So we may have a choir before long. And it would be nice. I have such beautiful new music that I brought this time. Composers who are really touching something of the overhead in music and bringing it down. There are many of them. Most of them in the Christian faith, but transcending that. Estonian, Polish, American, Canadian, so many different composers with the most beautiful music that we will sing. Okay, so we begin.
Again. Oh, no.
tired tonight, I think. Very humid. Now, doing this exercise, you should either feel some ringing in the ear, buzzing in the ear, or around the lips.
Because you see, you have those low notes. Amen. give the, I heard it. It's very good, both of you. Both of you, you're excellent.
This time. Good, one more time. Let's get it.
Seeks the divine, attempts to reascend by degrees towards the inaccessible, he forgets that all his knowledge and all his intuition cannot take him one step forward in this infinite. Neither does he know that what he wants to attain, what he believes to be so far from him, is within him. How could he know anything of the origin until he becomes conscious of this origin in himself?
Oh.
It is by understanding himself, by learning to know himself, that he can make the supreme discovery and cry out in wonder like the patriarchs in the Bible, "The house of God is here and I knew it not." That is why we must express that sublime thought, creatrix of the material worlds, and make known to all the world that fills the heavens and the earth, "I am in all things and in all being."
Thank you.
when all shall notice the promised day of great transfigurations will be at hand, when in each atom of matter man shall recognize the indwelling thought of God, when in each living creature they shall perceive some hint of a gesture of God, when each man can see God in his brother, then down will break, dispelling the darkness, the falsehood, the ignorance, the error and suffering that weighed upon all nature. For all nature suffers and laments as she awaits the revelation of the sons of God.
Thank you.
This indeed is the central thought epitomizing all others, the thought which should be ever present to our remembrance as the sun that illumines all life. That is why I remind you of it today. For if we follow our path bearing this thought in our hearts like the rarest jewel, the most precious treasure, if we allow it to do its work of illumination and transfiguration within us, we shall know that it lives in the center of all beings and all things, and in it we shall feel the marvelous oneness of the universe.